Corporate nationalists collude to impede the American democratic process in response to voter rights laws. This is a topic report. Corporations are not... I chose this image because this is like an image from the quote-unquote left, which is now, ironically, they're now relying on corporations for their power. Suddenly they're very corporate friendly, and notice that the right is suddenly not very corporate friendly, because it's all about the reality of power. People are understanding when corporations seem to reflect your values, you'll be pro-corporation. When they don't reflect your value, well, by values I mean the vehicle of power that you can enter into that advances your factional interests. And that's why you see nobody's being schizophrenic, nobody's being inconsistent. They're being very consistent. It's just that you're trying to understand people from a perspective of ideal rather than reality of power. And the reality of power, you can absolutely see why it is that suddenly conservatives are anti-corporate and suddenly leftists are, yay, mega corporations, mega faceless international corporations dictating to everyone what their morality should be. And that's what this really is. And it's more than that. Now they're going into politics. Top CEOs met on Zoom, more than 120 CEOs met on Zoom to mount new voting legislation effort, to mount new low vote. This is a political party now. There is a new political party, and it's called the Corporate Nationalist Party, and the only people that are in the Corporate Nationalist Party are the CEOs and the top, I mean the very, very top shareholders, the billionaires. This is your new political party. They don't have primaries. They have no accountability. They have monopolies, so they don't have to worry about actually delivering services to customers. So they don't have to worry about that. You've got to use their services no matter what. You've got to be employed by them no matter what. This is quote-unquote cooperation. This is the spirit of cooperation. That's why I'd outline the three methods of value exchange, and all of action is a form of value exchange the way I see it. And they are coercive. They're cooperative or they're consensual. I'm seeking consensual value exchange, and everybody else around me, a huge chunk of people, whether they're on the left or on the right, seem to be fine with cooperative value exchange. Now, the left is in favor of coercive and cooperative value exchange, but they like cooperative value exchange for the same reason that everybody else does. It's soft tyranny. It's less obvious tyranny. It costs people a lot less money to apply. Well, it costs a lot of money getting to that point, but once you get to that point where you have monopolistic control over any form of power, that's when cooperative exchange takes place, and that's when you have soft tyranny, and that's what we have right now. And this just makes it all the more obvious. The meeting, which took place Saturday via Zoom, was organized by Yale School of Management professor Jeffrey Sonnenfeld in conjunction with the Coalition for Inclusive Capitalism and the Leadership Now Project.
Words like capitalism, socialism, whatever, I'm not so interested in them, except for I do advocate for my brother's form of capitalism, but I'll let him describe that to you. And maybe you watch this video. We're going to have that show, the Big Freedomist show, and he'll talk to you more about that. And then we have corporations can't take freedom just because they're not government. This is from The Federalist. If you want to take over the world, build an American corporate empire to monopolize the public square and ban dissent. Then form a corporate coalition of like-minded peers who graduated from the same elite universities. They're the same rich families, too. Let's not forget the same billionaire families. Where wokeism is indoctrinated as a secular religion. They don't really care about this. This is just a really great vehicle of power for them. This is basically anti-competitivism. This is monopolism. There's moral monopolism and material monopolism, and they're going for both. And there's nothing more powerful than when you can use some moral constructs to tyrannize over the many and empower the few to tyrannize over the many. And significant portions of the many will do your bidding, largely because they'll buy the moral constructs that give them the power to murder their neighbors for reasons that are far beyond, from a Christian perspective, the Romans 13 paradigm of when the state can and should use coercive force. course of action against others. More than 100 of the nation's top corporate leaders met virtually on Saturday to discuss ways for companies to continue responding to the passage of more restrictive voting laws across the country, CBS News reported, in a signal that the nation's premier businesses are preparing a far more robust, organized response to the ongoing debate. Now, this isn't a debate. This is takeover. This is the takeover of the political sphere by our international corporatists, our corporate nationalists that have no accountability to the people whatsoever. And they just want to have their cake and eat it too. And so far, they have.